Welcome to the International Space Station Flight Control Room. I am here today. We were talking about some of the work that Koichi Wakata is working on today to install what is called the CubeSat deployer of the NanoRacks. And so here with me today is Mike Johnson. Mike is the NanoRacks Chief Technology Officer. Thank you for coming out to talk with us about CubeSat and its deployer and what's going on in space right now and some of the other payloads that have arrived on the Cygnus.
Yes, thank you. Just to briefly explain what NanoRacks does, we started out with flying payloads on the inside of the space station. And to date, we've flown approximately 120 payloads since 2010. And they range in spectrum from, say, biological experiments to little fluid experiments. We've flown a lot of high school and university experiments too. So we're as a company, we're trying to get, say, the normal person into space, if you will. And one of the things that happened last year, JAXA, the Japanese Space Program, gave us the opportunity to launch a CubeSat, which is a little small satellite. It's about 4 inches square cube, 4x4.
What I imagine.
Yeah, they're really small satellites. They're little cubes. It was a standard that was in devised about 2000, and they haven't flown a lot of CubeSats yet because they're kind of hard to fly on.
I think we're actually getting some video. This is from the small satellite deployment. This happened back in November.
Yes.
So it's very similar to that when it
yes.
launches out.
Okay. Exactly. And that was our second launch of CubeSats. Our first launch occurred in October of 2012.
Sure.
And so what happened at the company, we were originally going to use the Japanese JSOD deployer, which is a very fine system. But we realized that we started, the phones started ringing off the hook. Everybody wanted to fly CubeSats on the space station, launch them off the space station. So because of this high demand, we decided to fabricate these deployers.
And so you brought, actually, this is the deployer. So this is what Wakata is working
yes.
to install.
He's installing actually 8 of these deployers. To give you an idea, we have a total of 33 separate satellites that we flew up on Orbital 1.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we believe this will be a world record deployment of a number of satellites in one deployment. It'll take a few days. It'll take probably a couple weeks to deploy all the satellites from the space
station. And so how many is he going to have?
Well, today he's installing 8 of these deployers. It will take 2 experiment airlock openings to actually deploy all the satellites.
Okay.
So the
we're
first
getting some downlink right now.
Right, and what Koichi-san is installing here is the control box for the deployers, and then he later installed 8 of the deployers, and 8 is the maximum we could fit in the airlock.
Wow.
And so we're trying to maximize the airlock utilization. The airlock is just behind Koichi-san right now. And so once he's loaded all of the deployers onto this pallet, the MPEP pallet, it will go out through the airlock, and then the Japanese robotic arm will grab the pallet that he was putting the deployers on.
And so this here, this end, I don't know if you
sure.
can show this, but
sure,
this
show
is
this.
Is this where
this is a little launched? Door. It's like a little barn door that opens up. We've got the CubeSats. There are typically 2 satellites arranged in here, and they have a little spring on the back. And so this little actuator on the side here goes. It connects to the control box, and from the Japanese control center on the ground, they command to fire the satellites. Once the arm and everything's in position, they press the button, and that's what happens. The CubeSat deploys, and they actually go a little bit. The CubeSats are deployed a little bit below, and then they go in front of the International Space Station due to orbital mechanics, and so they get out of the way, say, of the space station, so they won't collide with the space station.
Okay.
And they begin their operations. So to give you an idea of what CubeSats actually do, we have the majority of our CubeSats on this flight right now are from a commercial company that is doing imagery work.
Okay.
Okay. The company's called Planet Labs, and they're basically these small telescopes. They're 3 cube units long, so about 300 millimeters by 100 by 100 millimeters, and they look down at the Earth and take pictures of the Earth.
Wow.
And eventually I think the goal is to send these images to people like Google Earth. So, you know, from a I guess from a user standpoint, this is probably one of the fastest links from space to Earth.
Yeah.
You know, you'll be able to look at your house on Google Earth from these satellites.
Well, that is exciting.
Now, we also have a couple other really exciting payloads on board, too, or CubeSats. We have two Lithuanian satellites and one Peruvian satellite. These satellites will turn these countries into spacefaring nations. They're the first satellites to be deployed in space from these nations. We also have a couple of other commercial CubeSats that we've flown on board too. But as I said, it'll take two airlock openings, so we'll be going probably throughout the better part of February deploying these satellites.
Well, that is very exciting. Thank you so much for coming. We're just about out of time here. But real quick, can you tell me about when are these to be deployed, the ones that he's installing now?
The first set would be February 6th, I believe we're going to start the deployments. And then the second set hasn't been scheduled yet, but it'll probably be a couple weeks later. So just a quick shout out, too. I have to say, this is all Texas built.
Texas built.
for our Texans in the room here. But Quad M, a local manufacturer up just outside of Austin, McDade, Texas, made most of this, and we're just really happy to put Texas folks to work on this.
Very good. Well, we are proud of Texas here in Texas.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for coming out again.
Appreciate it.
Is all very, very exciting and fascinating to hear about, and we'll be watching.
Thank you so
much. Thank you.